Cromway.
Heatmakers. Crack music.
Jones, crime and the murder rate. That rose up. Every time he got a bird and the crack rose up. I don't jog in Central Park, don't need mistaken identity. Watch for the scammers because they taking identities.
Your piece is hitting.
His 8 million stories on a daily basis.
Facts.
Niggas chasing dreams and catching scary cases. Remember pitching to the fiends until they clear the bases. I knew niggas that was wired like they wearing braces.
Check him.
Drug dealers and killers I was on corners with.
True.
Even played in the garden like I was on the Knicks.
Swish.
When I came through Harlem, all type of fun.
The scholarship fund, my Rosemary Thomas, which is my mother. She passed away a few months ago. I want to launch a book that I wrote about my character, my life, and playing overseas. And I want to launch it. I want to launch up, you know, my book to them and a scholarship fund that I want to kids that provide an essay. We'll pick out the best essays as a committee, and we'll give scholarships to these kids for various things for school. Maybe books, maybe clothing, whatever. We're gonna do it like that. We're gonna start up a high school scholarship, turn it into a college scholarship fund. So that's gonna be in honor of my mother.
This is Torey Thomas, professional basketball player, very good guy, and he's out of the kindness of his heart, always sponsors this league, all right? So the shirts are provided by him. This league's possible because he makes it possible, all right, guys? So if you kid, give him a round of applause, please.
Thank you, guys. Nobody. Some people like to read a little bit.
Yeah,
a little bit. So I'm gonna launch my first scholarship fund. So basically, how we gonna do it? We're gonna figure out who's gonna get these books that I'm gonna give you. I'm gonna give you a page to write about it. And if when y'all return it to us as a committee, there's gonna be a scholarship that I will give y'all based on what you wrote. And that means you can take this money and use it for school supplies, for school clothes, and then we'll keep up with you until it's time to go to college. So it's something new because I'm doing it in remembrance of my mom who passed away a few months ago. So I wanted to start it with a league that I helped, you know, grow all the kids here. So we're going to get little, Ariel's going to do something. You got something coming to you? You got something that they're going to do that? Because I got a few books I want to give them, and then if they, whoever wants to really read it, because I told them I got a scholarship fund after they read it and write about what they wrote.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So
all
we're going to do it.
All right, so we're going to break down.
You can break down. It could be something simple, but I just wanted to at least.
3.9.
What's up, man?
All right.
Knockout or something.
All right, we're going to do a quick game of knockout, guys. All right, so we're going to make two lines on each side of the court. So we're going to break it down in 1 second, okay? Wait for me. It's one or two. All right? If you're a two, you're on this side. If you're a one, you're on this side.
Fina,
one,
you like to read?
Two. One, so two. One, two. Two on this side.
I've been blessed with the ability to play basketball, come back home. The community cares for me, adores me. Oh, the best thing I could do is give back and show them, you know, a perspective, something that came from me. So I just hope that they see, you know, the vision that I see, and they can read about it, they can write about it, and they can discuss with me because I'm reachable. You know, I want them to be able to touch me, and I could touch them. So it's just an amazing feeling.
Single rims right here. They got the triple jumps. Any high.
I just completed my 12th season, man, since 2007, man. We're playing overseas. Very fortunate and blessed that we're still going. I have longevity in it, and I continue to hopefully play for some more years. What passion is this with the kids, playing ball, not just me personally playing, but watching basketball, seeing the kids develop. They have a program, so I enjoy it a lot. Played in Serbia, played in Italy, played in France, played in Sweden, played in Holland, man, played in Dominican Republic, played in Venezuela. All of these countries are beautiful, man. Played in Russia, Poland. Poland's like second home for me because of the embracement of the people with me and what I've done. So I've been to many places, and I could just say I learned about different cultures. Basketball is a high level. Played in Greece, played in Turkey. So I've been all over in Europe.
Maybe 14, 15, 16. So I'm gonna indulge a little bit of personal about myself. When I ran up on Mr. Thomas, I was actually at Downstate on work release. Mm-hmm. Mr. Thomas was either in his second or third year at Holy Cross, just making noise in the basketball community. Blessing in disguise? Yes, it was. Because basically what this man told me, you do right by me, I will do right by you. That was 30 years ago, mm-hmm. And I've been trying to do right ever since. His track record basically speaks for himself. Hardest working man in show business I have ever seen. He goes about it in a yeoman's fashion, which is basically second to none. That's why I appreciate the fuck out. I appreciate him so much. He's done so much for me, mental, physical, financial, social, exposed me to things that I probably never want to be exposed to a day in my life. I got blessed. I got to see sections of the world that the average black man just would not have seen. And look, I'm not dick riding anything like that. I'm telling it what it is.
Mm-hmm.
He's been a major attribute to my life, and he's touched thousands and thousands of others.
Yeah, big flaw is if you can't take staying away, being away from home, being away from your family for a long time, that is going to be that's a flaw, because you're going to be there 9 to 10 months without maybe not even a break. If they give you a break, it might be 5 days. So that's a big thing. The other thing is, yo, you have to try to immerse yourself in the culture a little bit, or you're going to go to practice and back home. So you're going to be bored, and you're going to think that is nothing for you. But it's so much more. Well, a big perk is traveling the world, eating new food, embracing new culture, people still playing basketball at a high level, and getting paid to play basketball. Those are perks. You're still getting paid, still a professional job, and you still can, you know, reach your goals.
I had to make sure that I got up about 6 a.m. My mom wake me up, make sure I had, you know, breakfast on the table, she was good. And then, boom, got up, shower, put my shirt and tie on, run down this hill to catch this bus, man. And then that bus, it was called the I-Bus, took me to Stamford, Connecticut. And that's where, you know what I'm saying, that's where my school was, Trinity Catholic in Stamford, Connecticut. So I had to take a bus into the train station, then another shuttle van from the train station across town, Stamford, which is actually a bigger city than what most people might think. Into Trinity, you know, every day. So that was like, you know, the sacrifice I made was leaving White Plains and the comfort of getting right at home, you know what I mean?
It was low-key preparing you for overseas, huh?
Man, it definitely did, because my independence was high at that. This is a 14-year-old kid leaving White Plains High after all his years of only knowing White Plains and taking on the opportunity of, oh, you got a good opportunity to go to a very good academic school and play basketball there. I mean, smaller classrooms for only 450 students. You know, it's co-ed. And, you know, shirt and tie, more discipline, structure, just a structure. That's what they give you. And that's what prepared me for overseas, for sure. I felt like it was one of the best decisions I ever made in my life.